In this particular patient, she was planning her procedure for a long time. She always felt that her nose looks very wide, and because of a previous trauma, she had fractured her nasal bone, giving her a deviated look and also problem in breathing. We corrected her fracture and reduced it to its normal stage. There was a deviated septum also that we corrected. You can see the on-table result, and once the swelling settles down, the result will turn out to be much better than what you are seeing at the moment. If you see the alar resection, the stitches that are used are very, very fine to approximate the skin edges with each other. But if the patient does not take care of using a lot of facial muscle and a lot of movement, these edges can spread, leading to bad scarring. Otherwise, they don't scar. It takes 1 year for these marks to settle down well, and because they are in the alar groove, they are not visible unless someone really wants to show by pulling their skin, "Look, I got a surgery done." Otherwise, in majority of the cases, this is not visible if proper precautions are taken. As I always say, that good result is in hands of both surgeon as well as patient. If they take proper precaution, they get excellent results. But if they don't take care, then the body does not take care the way it heals. If there is a lot of movement around the stitch line, the scars have a tendency to spread like this. So you can see these are two edges of the skin. They are approximated with very fine stitches close to each other. If they heal like this, there will be no scar. But if you keep on speaking, chewing, making a lot of movement around the scar, it can spread, leading to a wider scar. Otherwise, it's not visible. It looks like a hairline.
For more information, call on these numbers. Our managers would be happy to assist you. And if you want to know about the prices, please visit our website, our Insta page, and check the results of our patients.